All right, second take of Laramay's laugh, and I gotta say, I'm disappointed in YouTube right now. Maybe it's just the content of the video, but 50 Shades of Grey book review video, 3 weeks in and only 450 viewers. What the heck? When you got a guy falling off a treadmill that gets a bazillion views, what is it? I'm not funny enough? Maybe I'm not known enough? All right. I know the show in quotes, is a ripoff of Jim Rome, but honestly, Jim Rome is probably one of my biggest idols ever. And I figured I'm bored, I'm drinking, I'm home alone, my wife's at work. Let's just rip on stuff that I hate because there's nothing more than having stuff stew in the back of your head that you hate. So today, I'm gonna rip on, okay, maybe this is too close to softball guy, golf guy, whatever. I'm adapting the show. It's free for God's sakes. Intellectual property. It's a YouTube clip of me, and I'm not making money off of it. But hockey goalie guy. All right. You might know hockey goalie guy. I mean, hell, you might even be hockey goalie guy. And here's how you will know. Hockey goalie guy is like 30 years old. His hair's like half gone. Maybe it's because he's been wearing a helmet forever or whatever. Maybe it's because he works as a construction worker during the day and he has a helmet on. So his hair's doing that like receding thing when you wear a hat or something too much. But hockey goalie guy is the guy who's like 35 years old and he thinks that he could have been Mike Richter or Tim Thomas. And to make matters worse, he might actually be wearing a Mike Richter jersey. Or even better, the USA number 30 Ryan Miller jersey. And now I'm gonna get some people yelling at their computers going, "Ryan Miller wore number 39 for Team USA." Well, duh. That's why you're not hockey goalie guy. Because you didn't go and order a Ryan Miller number 30 jersey from some Chinese warehouse, thinking that you'd be cool because you had a Ryan Miller Olympic jersey. But anyway, hockey goalie guy's got on his jersey and he thinks he's all great, and nothing screams try hard beer league sports player than wearing a jersey of a guy you think you could have been if your parents didn't decide to talk with you and say, "Son, you know how many people actually become professional athletes? Not to mention, son, that you're terrible and you couldn't catch a beach ball with a fishing net, like the ones they use on like the deadliest catch or whatever. And dad and I are kind of sick of paying $300 for Patrick Waugh to come over every day, even though he'd rather be at his son's games beating up the referees." Because every family who lets their kid play hockey already has a six-figure income. And since your team's 0-20 and your goals against average is like 7, we've decided to pull you out of hockey and pay for you to actually go to college and become a real human being. But you've been devastated by this decision, and now you're playing at a dilapidated warehouse in like the shittiest part of town that was probably thriving in like the 1800s. The game starts, and hockey goalie guy lets in 4 goals while the other team doesn't even have a goaltender. Because the other goaltender isn't hockey goalie guy, it's guy playing beer league hockey who forgets that he has a shitty, non-important event in his life, and he checks his phone, and all of his try-hard friends with $100 sticks are like, Dude, are you coming to the game?" And he's like, "Oh shit, I have a game at 6, but I have a life. Oh wait, on my way, OMW." And he doesn't show up until the second period because he has other things to do than play hockey at a barn warehouse thing in the middle of Shittsville. In the meantime, though, your hockey goalie guy is getting shelled and getting more pissed off with every single goal. And now he's gonna take it out on all three of you, plus your three substitutes. "Dude, I was screened. Dude, guy playing goalie with no equipment just launched the ball 500 feet across the gym into the goal. Like, How were you screened? Were you even paying attention? I mean, okay, you have a valid point. You were screened by, like, the other six guys on the rink before the ball got to you. Okay, maybe there's a valid point there. But maybe if you paid attention, you could catch the big orange ball before it went through your legs like a cheap hooker in Las Vegas. But no, it's 5-1. Hockey goalie guy gets pissed and screams for a water break and then proceeds to glare at everybody on his team who supports him and who even invited him to come in the first place. Meanwhile, all the players are trying to assure the new guy. Oh wait, you figure out this is a personal anecdote and that I was a new guy. They're trying to reassure the new guy he doesn't usually play this bad when he's on his game. Well, it's 10 minutes into the first period, and it's 5-1. Is he really that good? So you're telling me that, what, maybe the score would be like 3-1? I mean, for God's sakes, the opposing goalie, in quotes, launched the ball from one end of the rink to the other, and it went in like he wasn't even there. I mean, the team name is the Phantoms, but your goaltender should not play like he's a phantom in real life. So this is what happens to hockey goalie guy later in the game. It's the second period. The score is 9-1, not even going to lie. And by now, the players are just done with this guy. He's having a quote-unquote off game, a.k.a. maybe he's just terrible and they just picked him up because there was no other guy to come. And now everyone thinks that the goaltender. Players are sprawling around, they're blocking shots, and of course this pisses off hockey goalie guy because he is the goalie and no one else should be saving or blocking or basically doing his job because he can't actually do his job. So here's little old me playing defense, blocking shots, and I come back out for another line change, and the guy who's really nice wants me to play defense, and I hear in my right ear, no, don't even do that to me, dude. Okay, wait a minute. It's 9-1 in the second period, and I've just sacrificed my body for 10 minutes for you, and the whole team has, and now you're going to come and bitch about how you don't want us to play defense for you. Well, specifically me, all right? That's hockey goalie guy. Hockey goalie guy is the guy who starts singling out players who he thinks he's better than, even though he's the one who's letting in goals, and you're actually blocking more shots than he's probably saving. He's the guy who, after every increasing goal, says, "What the heck, man? Why weren't you guarding that guy?" Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Why weren't you saving the ball that was shot 2 feet in front of your face, wide open? All right, sure, breakaways happen. Sure, goals get scored on breakaways. But really, when a guy is dipsy-doodling around you, like you're not even there, or like you're one of those rod hockey players who can only move one direction, then maybe it's not the fact that the guy ran past me and shoved me out of the way. Maybe it's the fact that you can't actually save anything in the world. So now the second period is over, and the goalie has switched his mindset from, okay, everyone on my team sucks, to, I'm just going to quit and piss everyone on my team off by not even trying because I'm too big of a head case. So by the end of the second period, it's like 11-2, and he's going in the back of his head, well, I'm going to show them I'm not going to try, and everyone's going to waste their whole time in the third period for the 20 minutes that we're still going to be here getting shelled. Nanny nanny boo boo. Because nothing shows more maturity than a 35-year-old guy wearing the number 30 USA Ryan Miller jersey who stops trying because he's the one who is letting in every single goal and who is terrible. Okay, so the third period comes along. It's like 11-2, like I said. And at his next water break, he proceeds to go over to the bench and bitch about how everyone on the other team is a faggot, and if they scored 100 goals a game, he would still think they're faggots. Because why? Because they scored 100 goals a game on you? Or a season on you? A season in floor hockey in a warehouse. But anyway, And then he starts ripping on the other team and how this person's this and this person's that and this person has no father and this person is adopted. And it just turns into this big rag on the other team because I'm mad because I'm terrible. So the end of the game comes and it's 14-5 because the referees decided to let some of those questionable goals count for your team. It's like a mercy rule or something. And, you know, everyone on the other team shakes your hand and says, good game. But he's the one. Okay, hockey goalie guy is the guy who, even though he has a terrible game, and even though it's all his fault, he storms off and shuns all of you like you're the reason why he had a bad game. He just bolts off the ice or arena or whatever you're playing on, goes into the locker room first, and sits in the corner and rips all his gear off as quick as possible so he can make a quick getaway. But the rest of the team, played like a team, is forgiving, catches up to him, and is like, dude, what happened tonight, you know? And by now, he's kind of run out of excuses. It was your fault. It was the team's fault. It was because the other team, I don't know, tries too hard or way actually knows how to play the game. So then it turns into the intangible. The guy who has nothing to do with the game except to drop the ball. You guessed it. The referee. And this happens with every fan who ever watches sports. Your team loses. It's not because your team sucked. It's because the referees, who you paid, or who the league pays, didn't ref the game fair. And he's sitting there taking off his number 30 USA Ryan Miller jersey. You guys are probably sick of that. And his $50 Coho pads, and his Coho helmet, and his Coho chest pad. Because also, hockey goalie guy is the guy who has to have all his equipment match and be top of the line. So he's sitting there ripping all of his gear off saying, well, you know, I got slashed like 10 times, and the referee didn't call it, and that's why I couldn't make the save. Really, you were getting slashed. Also known as, the guy was in the crease, smashing the ball through your five hole, and you were too lazy or hungover from your 1 o'clock bender that you couldn't just close your $100 pads and stop the big orange ball from going between your legs and scoring, like, what, the 12th goal of the game? And it's like, at this point, everybody on the team, not even the new guy who doesn't want to get punched in the jaw for disagreeing or talking out, everybody on the team is like, oh yeah, I know, right? You're getting slashed like 20 times, you couldn't make the save, and yeah, that guy totally hooked you, and you got punched in the face, and like, Mickey Mouse came out of the woodwork and distracted you, and like, you got blindsided by a train, and it just turns into this, everybody appease hockey goalie guy, because he's pissed off, drunk, or hungover, and he's angry at his whole life because he never got to play hockey as a kid because his parents decided to pull him out, like I said. And then everybody's kind of like, oh, hey, what are you guys doing next week? And everybody's like looking around going, I don't know. Maybe I'll come. Yeah, and I'll text you. And the guy, the goalie, is like, yeah, just text me and we'll find out what's going on. And everyone's like trying not to exclude him and try not to tell him that they don't want him to play anymore. But, you know, it's really hard to find goalies. You'd rather have a goalie who's terrible than, like, have no goalie and forfeit your warehouse league, bar, floor hockey league. So everyone kind of goes in different directions, and nobody talks, and it's all ridiculous and weird. Like, prom with that creepy girl that you just went with because she was the only one in the whole school that asked you out, and maybe you'll call her, and maybe you won't. And next week, it's the same old thing, and you'll be around with some other creepy girl or with some other hockey goalie guy who's terrible, or the same guy who's terrible because you're too afraid to tell him he sucks because he'll flip out at you and blame it on everything else. All right, this is another take of Laramay's Laugh, and out. This segment of Laramay's Laugh is brought to you by Admiral Nelson Spice Rum, Aldi Brand Coffee, and Powerade. Thank you, everyone.